Greetings and salutations. So Black Widow is a film. It's a film that I really liked. I originally wanted to make this video almost a full week ago now. I'm filming this video on Monday. I saw it Wednesday of last week, and I originally wanted to film this video either like Wednesday night or Thursday morning. But basically what happened was that I was like so emotional when watching the film that I was like, I do not think I can actually talk about this with any kind of real comprehension. Like, I knew that I watched it and was just completely clouded. I was just super biased, and I was like, I don't trust myself to give full judgment on this yet. So I waited until I watched it again on Friday night, and I was gonna film on Saturday, but then I had a depressive episode, and then I had plans yesterday, and like now we're here. But it was a journey, and I apologize that I waited this long to talk about the film. Now, I don't know how to talk about this film because there are so many things I want to say that I'm going to be jumping all over the place, but just massive spoiler warning, I am not really going to say anything without spoilers. Besides, it's good, it's a good Marvel film. If you like Marvel movies, you'll enjoy this. I think this movie works better if it's relatable to you on any way, shape or form. So I think its target audience are women, and I think that the people who are going to be the most moved by this film are people who can connect with the story. If you enjoy Marvel movies, like, it's a good Marvel film regardless, so you'll have a lot of fun, and I think it has the best fight scenes in the entire MCU. So that's my spoiler free thoughts. Now we're just gonna go straight into spoilers. Also, I tried to a little bit of a Yelena moment today. I tried to a little bit of her like eyeliner, but like a subtle way, because eyeliner like that does not suit me. So I did like a subtle thing, and I also, you can't really tell, but I do have two ponytails. Cause so, you know, be like, what's that thing you always do with it's a fighting pose. Okay, so this film, yeah, the first time I saw it, I was just so emotional because it is just such a personal story to me. This entire film is talking about human trafficking and the sexualization of young women and the dehumanization of young women and women's right to choose. And that's such a powerful, powerful topic. And I'm so grateful that this film exists. I was so moved by it. I was also so deeply moved by the themes and the way that the themes are displayed of family during this film. As someone who, like Natasha, and something that I really related to with Natasha so much when I was first getting into the MCU and throughout my entire life, is that I don't feel necessarily that I have family. I have always felt very, very out of place in my actual blood family, because I grew up in a very emotionally abusive household, and so I always felt very out of place there and that I didn't belong, and I never was close with any extended family. And then I've been searching for like a found family my entire life and never felt like I found that either, or when I have, that's fallen apart very quickly. The way that the themes of family and just having family, whether that's in regards to Natasha's, the family that we see, Alexi and Yelena and all of them, or in the, just thinking of her family to the Avengers, it was really, really moving for me in that regard as well. So I was just an emotional wreck the first time I saw this film. Now that I also saw it with a much clearer head, I can safely say that I think this is good. It has problems, and I don't think there is any Marvel film and any MCU film that is without flaws and without some little breaks in logic, but they don't bother me that much. I've seen some people get really angry about moments where, like, towards the beginning of the film, after Natasha and Yelena first meet for the first time, they kind of like jump on this pole and kick off of it because there's another widow under the brainwash, like, following them. Natasha basically falls and hits a bunch of things, then lands on her feet and goes up to the other widow. And a lot of people are like, how the fuck can she survive this? But she gets, you know, killed in Vormir. And a lot of people were like really angry about that, but they really didn't bother me that much. I think there are a lot of logical leaps you have to make in a lot of Marvel films to just believe things. And so that moment didn't bother me. The fact that everyone falls from the sky and doesn't die at the end doesn't really bother me either, especially because I know it was never confirmed in the MCU, but I always just assumed that in the MCU, Natasha had some kind of serum. That's what gives her kind of a lot of agility. A part of it, as well as on Vormir, she wasn't trying to survive. She probably fell and in a way that maximized her death. And also, like, Vormir is a magical place where the whole point of it is you throw someone off the cliff, they die. So yeah, I'm gonna believe that potentially there was magical forces on Vormir that make her die. So none of that really bothered me. Another major complaint that I've seen about this film is about the villains, whether it be, I've seen a lot of people complain about what they do with Taskmaster, and a lot of people complain about just Dracov in general. And I actually disagree with a lot of those complaints on both accounts, or at least what I've seen of them. Obviously, if you were disappointed that you didn't see the Taskmaster that you're familiar with in comics, and if you're really excited to see that specific Taskmaster, and obviously then you weren't delivered with that, I completely understand that disappointment, and I'm not trying to invalidate that at all. I completely understand that. However, I don't think it's a bad move or the be all end all because we had Taskmaster be Dracov's daughter, because specifically we don't actually hear her be called the Taskmaster. We hear that she is a Taskmaster in the Taskmaster program. And to me, that felt very much so like how in Iron Man 3 we had the Mandarin and he was a fake out, and then now we're getting the real Mandarin in the MCU very soon. I feel like we're gonna have the same situation with Taskmaster here, where this will be a Taskmaster under a Taskmaster program who was replicating something to do with the real Taskmaster that we'll see in the future. I just think we'll see the real Taskmaster in the future. I think that they've left that very open-ended for the real Taskmaster to come back, and I think they will utilize that, especially considering the popularity of the character and just how much they've merchandised Taskmaster already here. They obviously know the popularity of that character, and I think I completely believe that we will see the real Taskmaster in the future. So that didn't bother me. And I think that having the Taskmaster be Dracov's daughter opened this really interesting discussion about how, and this is really not talked about much, but it is a massive problem. So many women are assaulted by family members. So many women are thrown into sex trafficking by family members. That's not something that's very talked about, obviously, because it's a horrible thing. Hi. Obviously, because it's a horrible thing that we don't like to talk about, which I understand, but it brought that into the discussion in a really interesting way and could conjure up those discussions for other people and those conversations, which I think is a really, really good thing. And I think that was really interesting and it fit the themes of this film really, really well. In terms of Dracov being a disappointing villain or like a meh villain, I understand the complaints because we don't see very much of him. We don't really see him at all besides one scene until the third act. And a lot of people, I think, then felt that he was underutilized or boring or underwhelming. And I think because we don't see him be a traditional villain, we don't see him be physically powerful, we don't see him be physically intimidating besides the pheromone thing, I think a lot of people were disappointed by that. Whereas I am someone who complains a lot about Marvel villains, I don't really have any complaints with Dracov here. I think if we saw more of Dracov, it would have hurt the story, because Dracov isn't meant to be physically intimidating. He's not meant to be beating Natasha up in battles. The whole reason he's powerful is because he has this control over women. He has created this environment where he preys on young, inexperienced women who can't help themselves because they're children. He preys on that and then turns them into women he can control. I think if we saw more of him, or if we saw him be more typically of a villain, or even if we saw him have more of a, his whole motivation really is that he hates women. And that works in the theme of this story, which is just about women's rights. That fits this theme well. We don't need him to be talking about his plans for world domination. We don't really need to know why he has the red room. We just need to know that he has, I'm so sorry about my cat making noise. We just need to know that he has this power and that he's using this power to keep his own power. He's using the widows that he has everywhere and the control he has over them to create more widows. He finds girls disposable. It doesn't matter if some don't survive the program, it doesn't matter to him. And I think if we saw him have more normal villain motivations, that would have really hurt the impact of that aspect of his character. Anyway, I've already been filming for 10 minutes and I've said like nothing about the film. It's really funny. I was surprised because so much of this film was so heavy and so much of it was subject matter that is so close to home and is a little bit triggering for me, that I was surprised at how much I was laughing. But Florence Pugh as Yelena obviously is incredible. Florence is like one of the most talented actresses working nowadays, but like just her as that character, she steals every scene she's in. She's so funny. Her comedic timing is brilliant. And David Harbour is also hysterical. I nearly cried at how hard I laughed at some of his things. He's trying to bond with Yelena and he goes, "I was fishing with my father and I stuck my hands in to catch the fish and I got frostbite," and he's telling that story. And then Yelena's like, "What does this have to do with anything?" And he just goes, "You know, fathers." I laughed so hard at that. I laughed so hard at every fake, you know, moment where he was trying to connect with Natasha, or he was doing some big emotional thing and like, they couldn't hear him, his comms went on, or it wasn't Natasha. It was so funny. Everything about this film was so funny. The moment right at the end where Yelena goes like, I can't remember if it's Yelena or Natasha, but they ask if everyone's okay, and you know, Yelena goes, "I'm clearly injured." I laughed so hard at that. I loved the costuming and the makeup in this film. I was very, very happy and grateful to see a character that I grew up idolizing and loving, and a character that means so much to me and has such a history of being sexualized in a film where her suits are zipped up. They look more practical, and just her not being objectified by the camera every 3 seconds, and her just not being sexualized, her having like a full character motivation and having a real strong emotional arc and having her written like a human was so fantastic. And like, yeah, I hate Scarlett Johansson, but she does a great job in this film. Everyone in this film does a great job. The opening title sequence was harrowing. Oh my god, can we also just give a shout out to the fact that Natasha Romanoff had blue hair as a child, and I also had blue hair I was 14 when I had it, but like as a teenager. Blue hair gang, me and Natasha Romanoff, we're the same. I was surprised at how much I loved all of the supporting characters in this film, because something I think is a problem with certain Marvel films, not all, but sometimes when you bring in like a whole group of sidekicks, like more than just one or two, especially because none of these characters are characters we've seen before, they can get really like lost. They can feel really annoying or underdeveloped. And I think Thor is like a great example of this. We've improved on it, but I think nowadays in most Marvel films, the sidekicks are characters we're already familiar with. Even in one of my favorite films, Black Panther, like I think Okoye and obviously T'Challa and Killmonger and Shuri are written really, really really well, and we get them fleshed out, but like every other character, not so much. I feel like they could have had more character work done. It was nice to me that I felt that I really understood each side character's motivations. I thought they all had clear personalities. I thought they were all very humanized. None of them felt like caricatures, which is really, even though some of them were the comedic relief, they all had real emotional weight, and I understood where they were emotionally, and that's because the actors were doing such a great job, but also because it was really well written. I just thought it was great. I think the pacing in this film is incredible. This film does not feel like 2.5 hours, and I just thought the pacing of it was absolutely incredible. Just 10 out of 10 pacing. Really, really good. I was surprised at how much I related to Yelena in this film, because I have always related really, really deeply and like really strongly to Natasha, and I really relate to how Natasha feels regarding her family in this film and the way that she holds her parents accountable. But then I also felt so seen and understood by that scene of Yelena crying, going like, "It was real to me. The best years of my life were fake and none of you told me." As someone who was the youngest, not the youngest blonde sibling, but the youngest sibling in a family that was really non-conventional, and the realities of my family are a lot sadder than the realities of Yelena's, because it was real to all of them. But just her breaking down in that way and just being so in denial for a long time about what her family really was, and just thinking of the happy memories and clinging to the idea that it was real, that hit so close to home for me. That scene is just so fucking powerful. Yeah, I'm now a Yelenakin too. Like, I relate to how Natasha and Yelena like cope with their family in such a deep way, and having those two cases of seeing how they coped with and came to terms with what their childhoods were, but also having both of them be so human and so relatable. This is a really special film. It's really well written. The character work here is incredible. Obviously the end credits made me lose my mind. We'll be watching Hawkeye to see Yelena kill him. I hope she does. I hope she succeeds. I feel very validated by having at least one other character in the MCU who agrees that it should have been Clint. Thank you. But I will be looking forward to seeing Yelena murder Clint's ass. I love when women. I also think that's something that's really interesting about that end credit scene is when you look at everything that's on the ground, when you look at all the gifts that have been laid out for Natasha, there's not evidently anything from the Avengers there. I understand why Kate, the director of Black Widow, wouldn't have put anything from the Avengers there, because they didn't give her a funeral and they haven't really seemed to be grieving Natasha that much, and so she's just going on with those vibes. But it also felt really out of character to not have anything from the Avengers there. I've seen a lot of people talking online about how it's really odd and implying that the Avengers were bad friends or a bad family to Natasha for not knowing about, you know, Yelena or Alexei or any of Natasha's family. To me, what I think happened there, and this is part of me just justifying it to myself, my assumption was that they got blipped. Natasha personally felt a lot of the guilt for that, and while we see Natasha open up to Steve and Clint especially, like Steve and Clint especially, more so in the later years, something that Natasha struggles to open up with, and we see it in this film, is she struggles to be honest about things that she feels immense guilt over. And so I can understand and I can believe that if her family were blipped and she found that out and she took that on personally, felt that she did that herself, she would have dealt with that pain privately and wouldn't have told the Avengers about that other family, because she struggles to bring up these things that she feels such intense guilt over. And that seems in character to me, and that's how I've been justifying it, what I've been assuming happened. Although the thought of like Yelena waking up after being blipped and Natasha being dead is heartbreaking, but I also think that makes sense almost on Vormir, why Natasha is so ready to die for the cause, whatever it takes, because she's bringing back her family. And I think Natasha obviously was already so ready to do it, because she finally just wants to get that red out of her ledger. And I love the theories about Natasha's hair color and how she was blonde in Infinity War, because she finally felt that she'd gotten the red out of her ledger, and then it's, you see the red growing back in because she feels like she's got red back in her ledger after not being able to save everyone from Thanos. I love those theories, and I think you can just look at that and be like, yes, this is enough motivation for Natasha to be ready to do whatever it takes on Vormir. But I think that fits in with it more. My justification of everything is that, but then because I've justified everything that way, then having like no gifts from the Avengers on the floor, like nothing from Bruce, nothing from Pepper, nothing from Okoye, who worked with her for years, nothing from Carol, worked with her for years, and nothing from Sam. They went on the run together. Like, it's implied in Infinity War that they were on the run together for a long time. Like, nothing from any of them, really. It felt out of character, but I understand why we didn't see anything visually that would have been like, we know who put that there. But it felt out of character, and it was very upsetting, because I like to think, because I relate to Natasha so much and I want to find my own little Avengers family, I would like to think that I'll find a family someday who I believe are family and then appreciate me as family. And if I die for them, they, you know, appreciate me after I'm dead too. But oh my God, that fucking moment where Natasha starts smiling. She's like, all of that from that little desk. And he's like, what do you find funny? And she's like, don't take it personally, but thank you for your cooperation. The way in which I yelled. Oh my God, I want to cosplay Yelena so bad. I want to cosplay White Widow so bad, but I do not have the money. But that is my favorite suit of hers ever, I think. Oh my God, oh, the little braids that they have in the hair. If I just wear my hair constantly in double ponytails or braids for the next, I wore my hair in braids yesterday and I'm wearing a double ponytail today. But if that's all, that's just how I wear my hair from now on, then that's just how I wear my hair from now on. I'm okay with that. I'm a changed woman. Hi, I'm so sorry if you can hear my washing machine in the background, but just while editing this, I realized that I didn't touch on two complaints that I actually have about this film. And the first is the CGI. It looks pretty shit in some instances, not as bad as Black Panther, but the way that I defend Black Panther and the CGI in Black Panther a lot is that they had such strict time restrictions, like they just were not given enough time to properly do that CGI, whereas because of COVID delays, they had quite a bit of time to fix the dodgy CGI here and pay those visual effects artists like overtime, pay them more, hire them again, fix things up. They didn't, so I don't think there's any excuses for the like shoddy CGI. But that is what it is. And my other complaint is that this does just feel weird. The timing of this film feels odd. The fact that we are jumping into phase four and we're having a film that's set right after Civil War, it's set in 2016, it feels a little odd. And I do agree. I know that Scarlett Johansson and the director have said that the actual story of this film could not have been told prior. And I do believe that. I don't think this specific story from Marvel Studios could have been made prior to, you know, the Me Too movement. And just socially, I don't think it could have been made earlier, but it does feel like a weird placement. I do wish that we were able to have gotten this film after Civil War, where it was placed in the story, so that it could have just felt more natural, because it does feel weird to be starting off phase four with a film set in 2016. But it is what it is. I'm grateful this film exists now, and I hope that somehow we get more Yelena content, because this is doing pretty well financially. So obviously we can't get more Natasha stuff now, but I hope that we get a Black Widow trilogy focusing on Yelena and the other widows or something. It would be really interesting. Yeah, those are my complaints. Thank you. Anyway, complaints aside, thank you so much for watching. Please talk to me about this film in the comments, whether you loved it or you disliked it for whatever reason or what issues you had with it. Please talk to me about it. I would love to just have really in-depth discussions about this film. Whatever your opinion is about it, I just would love to talk about it. And I love hearing differing opinions, but I also love just yelling about things that I love with people who love the same things. So whatever you feel about this film, if you would like to discuss it respectfully in the comments with me, please do. I love you very much. Thank you for watching. Mwah!